Hey guys, how's it going? Well, a few of you have been asking me for a review video on my John Deere 322 that I recently picked up, so today I decided I'd make one. So here it is. I'll give you a walk around. This is exactly how I got it. I bought it from a used mower place back in end of December. This tractor is a 1988 model. Sorry about the wind. But anyway, so this tractor is very similar to the John Deere 332, except it's gas. This has the Yanmar 3-cylinder, 18 horsepower gasoline engine. And it's very similar in design to the John Deere 332 with the 16 horsepower Yanmar diesel, except this one is gas. So anyway, here's the engine. And as you notice, it is missing the side panels and dash tower screens and panels. This is how it came. I haven't done anything to it. It's missing the taillights also. But anyway, here's the engine. It has 1121 hours on it, which isn't a lot for these liquid cooled machines. At least liquid cooled engines, if they're taken care of, will run 5,000 hours tops. I mean, they might even go farther than 5,000 hours, but as long as they're maintained, these were built to run. So as you can see here, this engine is a Yanmar 3TG66UJ. Very similar to the 332 engine, which is a 3TN66UJ, except it's diesel. This one has a carb, a different intake, like a gas intake. Three coils, pulsers on the flywheel. And of course, has a radiator. And it does not have an injection pump. It has a carburetor. But other than that, this is the same block. This is basically a diesel engine block. And it does not have the injectors. It has spark plugs. Or glow plugs. But yeah, kind of give you a walk around with the hood up. As you can see, it's in pretty good shape, but it is missing paint up near the grill. And this tractor is powder coated. They started powder coating these in 1988. And this is an 88 model. They made the 322 from 1988 to 1992. So this is a first year. And I'll fire it up for you. See, it runs pretty quiet. And also, these did have the, this does have the electric fuel pump. You can see it down there. Yeah, right there. Electric fuel pump on these. And as you can see, this one runs pretty good for having 1121 hours on it. Oh, another thing about these is the radiator is just big enough for the engine. These are known to overheat. But as long as you keep the radiator fins clean, you shouldn't have any problems with these. But I've heard stories of 332 owners and 322 owners overheating their tractor because, you know, they mow and whatnot and the radiator clogs up. They don't clean it, so it runs really hot. But yeah, as you can see, it's kind of got a little stumble to it, but you know, the car might need to be cleaned. It has older gas in it. And as you can see, it runs really smooth. Very different compared to the Onan engine in the 318. The only similarity between this engine and the Onan engine in the 318 is this, they both run on gasoline. Otherwise, they're, everything's different on them. And I found out this was an 88 model by, you know, because it didn't have the tag on the dash tower panel. And I looked on the hood and there's a sticker down there. You can see it right there. And it says 5/18/1988. So the hood was made in 88. I assume the tractor was made sometime around then. But yeah, it runs flawless. And as you can see here, these, compared to the 318 and 316 Onan, this fender pan was cut out to accommodate for this, the radiator. Super 18 didn't have this cutout because it didn't need a radiator because of air-cooled owning engine. Sorry about that. But yeah, as you can see, it runs pretty good. And I do have plans for it. I'm planning to turn this into a worker machine. And because I have future plans to restore my 1987 through 18, so, you know, I'm going to need a tractor to do the chores around here and whatnot. So I plan to give the engine a tune-up and power wash the whole tractor, change the hydraulic, you know, transmission oil and stuff, and also change the fuel pickups in the tank because they do rot out and they fall in the tank. And you got to run these with a full tank of fuel so they can get it. And as you can see, this does have neutral creep. It creeps backwards. I don't know how well you can see it, but it is creeping. So I got to look into the hydro linkage. Some of the bushings and whatnot might be worn out on it, but that won't be too hard to fix. So yeah, it does creep in reverse. The brakes need to be adjusted. The pedals aren't right. So, pretty minor. Mechanically, it's sound, but you know, I do have to look at that neutral creep. Yeah, I'll hop on and take it for a spin. And as you can see here, you have your oil pressure light, battery light, coolant light, or water temperature light, and then your PTO lights. And then this has a low fuel sensor in the tank, and it'll tell you if your tank's low. So that light will go on if you're almost about to run out of fuel, gasoline. And that sensor in the tank, what it does is it senses the temperature difference in the tank because the gasoline is slightly cooler than the air temperature. And when that temperature changes, it fires this light on, tells you that you're low on fuel. So, take it for a spin here. Give it some throttle. It does run pretty well. Very smooth. My yard's bumpy, sorry about that. Does run noticeably different compared to my 318. It's a lot quieter with the liquid cooling. I'm at like low throttle right now, just putting around the yard. Take you down my driveway. There's my 1145 right there. Go down here. I really need to get a knob on my steering wheel, and it also needs a cap with a leaping gear on it. I have one of those. I just gotta put it on. Like I said, this tractor is as is. I haven't done anything to it since I bought it. Go full speed, so something's up. I got to look at it when I get the fender pan off. Take it for one more loop around my house, and then I'll hop off. It is pretty hilly around here, but this tractor does excellent on hills. No problems whatsoever. I'll squeeze around this tree. I'll do go up this hill real quick. Give it some throttle. yeah, this machine feels like it's got a lot of life left in it. 1120 hours isn't necessarily high for one of these. These engines will go 5,000 plus if you take care of them the right way. But anyway, I'll hop off for a minute and show you around. The idle I need to work on. And if you've watched videos on 322s or seen them run, they do have a hesitation when you manipulate the throttle fastly. As you can see here, the engine kind of, it'll hesitate. And there it didn't, but as you can see, there's a delay. And that's because this carburetor lacks a fuel accelerator pump. So what that accelerator pump does is when when the throttle linkage is depressed, it squirts a little bit extra fuel in there, and you know, it accommodates for that delay. So that's why kind of why this thing stumbles, because there's, you know, a delay. It takes a bit of time to get that extra fuel pumped up there when you hit the throttle, but otherwise it runs really well. Oh, and yeah, another thing I want to show you is this does, someone put this on here. It's like aftermarket push button start where the rear PTO knob could go. I could take that off if I got a rear PTO, but yeah, let me show you how that works. So you put the key on, dash lights go on, hit that, fires right up. So that's pretty cool. I'll do it again. Yep. That push button start is pretty cool. I might leave that on there. I've got to make a decision about that. But, you know, it doesn't seem to hurt anything. And it starts just as well with that. And also I won an eBay auction for a set of side panels for this. The screens in the front, the right, correct 322 side panels. So I'm going to get those on there. And I've also got the dash panel towers and screens that cover all this up. The screen goes right there. But yeah, as you can see, the transmission's got that creep to it. And it doesn't have a seat switch, so it will go on its own. But anyway, yeah. So this is 322. Definitely a keeper. I'll go up my front yard real quick. There you go, there's a 322. So thank you for watching my video. Please comment, rate, and subscribe.